I wanted to have a business that was friendly, that was appealing to people, that was American all the way, and that's what we've created. People like the store because everything is well organized, everything is clean. Very seldom would you ever see anything in here that was made in China. Prices are very reasonable, and we're very friendly. We love our customers, and we really work with our customers to help them get what they want. Our vendors are really pretty special because most of them are our retirement age. But they've been doing antiques for 15, 20 years. I've got one in here that's been doing it for 30 years. And along memory lane, what that means is you're working with people who really know the business, who understand the age of items, the authenticity, and they also understand the pricing. That's really important because if you don't have that kind of quality in your shop, people tend to steer away. Well, the one thing that has really bothered me is the fact that there's so many pieces of beautiful furniture out there. And a lot of it is from 1930s, 1940s, 1950s, and it's out of style now. And when I discovered what chalk paint was all about, I realized we could really make a difference. And with chalk paint and the older furniture, you can do that. So right now, we do carry Dixie Belle paints. We use them on everything that we paint. We've got several people who are really, really wonderful, wonderful painters. They can take an old piece and make it look glorious. And so I'm finding that people are attracted to this, and we have a hard time keeping up sometimes. This is the old hardware store, the Seville Hardware Store, and it was started in 1903. And about 8 years ago, it closed down. And I rode past it for probably 6 months, just wanting so bad to try to take that next step. And then I plunged. I still get old farmers who come in the door, walk up to the counter, and want to know where some electrical supplies are or some plumbing supplies. And then they look around and they say, "Isn't this the hardware store?" And so you know they haven't been in for a while, but we still have those folks coming in looking for the hardware store. Well, I've always collected things for myself. My kids can remember being at an auction under a sleeping bag when it was raining because I wanted a butter churn. And I did get the butter churn. But I've always loved these things. But you know, life carries you in different ways. And I had jobs that had nothing to do with antiques. And then I retired. And when I retired, I couldn't sit still, so I decided to get a part-time job, and that was in an antique store. And that's really what set it off, because I met the other people in the business, and they're great people. They truly are. And then I became really kind of fascinated by the whole process of buying and selling and researching, and it was like a fever, and it just kind of mushroomed into what you see here.